Δημήτρη, χαίρετε. Είμαι εδώ στο Innsbruck. Σήμερα έχει αχέπατο Epiphany Banquet και τώρα έχουμε εδώ κοντά μας το Λεωνίδα Ραπτάκη. Να το καλωσορίσουμε στο Τάπος Prince στη Φλόριδα και πάλι που έρχεται για τα Θεοφάνια. Τι γίνεται, κύριε Ραπτάκη, πώς πας? Ο Σένετος Ραπτάκης είναι με το Δημοκρατικό Κόμμα. How do things with you?
Well, good. We had a very important election victory again, and this is my second home. We've been here for 3 years. We have a condo in Bel Air Bluffs, and my wife and I are here almost every other month. So this is a second home, and it's important to be here every year to celebrate the Epiphany. But it's more important is to be with the Greek American community, and there's a lot of issues right now that a major concern between the United States and Greece, as you can read on a daily basis in the news. There's issues with the name Macedonia, there's the Aegean Sea, the Turkish issue, the Greek economy, and trying to build better bridges and bonds between Greece and the United States. I'm proud to be a Greek American legislator, and this year we had tremendous victories all over the United States, where we have 6 members of Congress, we have over 12 state senators and about 26 to 30 members of the state houses across the United States, which compose about 16 states. We have Greek Americans elected in 16 states out of the 50. That's a huge, huge number. It means a lot of access and a stronger voice in Washington, D.C.
Πες μου κάτι, πες μου κάτι, Mr. Ραπτάκης. How the we go to the Greek issues for a minute, then we come back to the United States issues. How do things they look like for Turkey, which keep attacking Greece, and now Trump, they move very slow progress the American army from Syria, and Turkey's move Laro army to North Syria, south of Turkey, and they try to destroy the Laro Kurdists. What do you think about that?
Well, the issue here right now is that the United States and Greece have strong relationships. Ambassador Pai has been doing a good job in Greece with the Thessaloniki Trade Fair, bringing U.S. companies. The Port of Alexandroupoli, which I was just there about 2 weeks ago, meeting with the mayor, the governor, and also our military installations in Suda Bay with the expansion of other facilities in Larissa. I think that issue between Turkey and Greece is serious, but I think the United States is going to play a vital role in supporting Greece in a lot of the issues. I know Syria is important also, we're trying to find a common ground and solution in Syria. But again, my worry is that the Kurdish army has played a key role in defeating ISIS, and I'm very surprised and shocked that President Trump decided to leave Syria and leave the Kurds exposed to Turkey. Turkey has not been a good partner. Our role here in the United States also is to block the F-35s, and many members of Congress have met with Admiral Postimakis, who's been here 3 to 4 times. They respect the Admiral, the Joint Chief of Staff of the Greek Armed Forces, and I think we've come a long way. So I think the issues here are very important, and I think regarding the it's a two-pronged issue. Supporting Greece militarily, Greece playing a vital role in the Eastern Mediterranean, in getting Greece out of the economic issues, the economic crisis. I don't think the U.S. is going to abandon Greece, and I don't foresee Turkey. Turkey makes these threats on a daily basis. They've been doing it for weeks, months, and years, the overflights. I know it's an annoyance for Greece, but I don't believe that Turkey will take upon himself to try to either invade Greece or try to take over any Greek islands. I mean, look, Greece is part of the EU, part of NATO. The sad part about it is where you have one NATO country always making threats upon another NATO country, and NATO and the EU should step up to the plate and really step up to the plate and tell Turkey, look, you know, if you're going to take that behavior, we should really consider your NATO membership. And I think the EU should play a greater role, and they haven't.
Yes.
They haven't.
Yes.
And I think the other issue is the energy issue with Cyprus, Israel, and Greece. The U.S. really has to step up to the plate and also tell Turkey, you know, enough's enough. We're gonna honor and recognize Cyprus's rights, Greece's rights, and also Israel. So let's see what happens with ExxonMobil and Total and Eni being a key role partners in, with Cyprus and Greece exploring energy and not having any more of these Turkish threats. That's where you draw the line. That's where the red line should be drawn, with the United States to really put their foot down and have a stern warning to Turkey. Erdogan is erratic. He's erratic and he's a dangerous person. So I don't know if he's doing it because of the internal crisis that Turkey is facing economically. So I think the right now the key major role is to support Greece, get Greece out of the recession, get Greek youth back employed, reduce the unemployment. We know there's going to be elections coming up in 2019. TIFF was very important, the Thessaloniki trade fair, and U.S. military participation in Greece, because Greece right now is going to be pivotal in the Eastern Mediterranean. But make sure that our words mean something. I'm saying about the United States.
Yes.
U.S. is going to be investing a lot in Alexandroupoli with the LNG.
Yes.
And let's be honest. Let's make sure that Greece and the United States continue this long-lasting partnership. But U.S. is true to its words. Very important.
Let's get back here in the United States. Now we see Trump have shut down the government. And I posted before on my blog that was over 2019 or 29 times there was shut down the government. Many times. But Trump said, you know, they can work with Pelosi and Ton Evreo Americanos in
Chuck Schumer, U.S. Senate
Schumer,
Minority Leader.
Which he's the guy, he's, I told you the truth, you know, like I feel like very bad about that guy, because a long time ago he said, first in Israel, and then I put the United States. He said that. He said, first Israel, and then the United States. And I don't know why the people in New York, they vote for him. And then most of the Greeks. I tell them, I don't give my vote. Nothing against the Democratic Party. But people, when they say that, first, it's like me, run for Congress. I said, first Greece, and then you guys. That's embarrassing for this country.
Being elected here in the United States, whether we're Greeks, Italians, Jewish descent, whatever, Germans, Hispanic.
And then Jewish people, they have the majority. They got 32 congressmen in their Democratic Party.
Yeah,
and
there are
only two in the Republican Party.
Look, there's a lot of emotion right now with the government being shut down. That's sad to see so many people, 800,000 government workers,
I know,
without a paycheck. Trump, the administration, with the U.S. Senate and the U.S. House of Representatives have to sit down to find a resolution. And this cannot go on. We've had longer shutdowns in past administrations with Obama and Reagan. But again, enough. We've got to come to a consensus. Look, government, the Democratic Party and the Republican Party all have to work together to try to
find why the Democratic Party, 4 years ago with Obama, they do exactly the same job like Trump's done on this immigration. They keep said, we want to build up the wall, we want to control the immigration. Why now they're against, and they said, open the sinora, open the boards.
Both parties have to sit down and truly find a resolution, because if they don't, we're going to continue with the same broken record, future government shutdowns, nothing's going to happen, and we, again, in 2 years from now, right now, we're going to have a stagnant government. People are going to understand that even though Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats control the House of Representatives, you cannot pass legislation without the Senate approving it and without President Trump vetoing it.
Yes.
Unless there's a partnership between all three branches, the President, the U.S. Senate, and the U.S. House of Representatives working together, you're not going to get nothing done.
Nothing.
Absolutely nothing. And people got to understand that the House can pass as much legislation as you can. The Senate could pass it, but if the President vetoes any type of legislation, cannot override his veto, nothing's going to happen.
That's going to happen. The other things now, they said, like, about the Social Security. The Democrats, they want to cut the Social Security down. And also the Medicare. Do you ever hear anything like that?
Rumors go around. No, I never heard anything like that. You can't touch Social Security, Medicare.
Nobody's can. That's what I keep telling them. Nobody's can touch.
I'd be totally. I mean, I'm not in the Congress, but you cannot cut it. I mean, there should be increasing Social Security and Medicare.
I know.
Tie it to the CPI and give a true increase. I mean, it's
yes.
A lot of seniors are suffering, and they cannot survive. And the problem with the seniors is, you raise the Social Security minimal, and then they get an increase in their housing. Doesn't work out.
No.
Where are they going to play catch up?
No.
I really think that we got to thank that generation. They've done a lot for this country to build this country what we have, and we should be saying thank you.
Yes. Okay. Λοιπόν, να έχεις χρόνια πολλά, πάντα επιτυχίες.
Ευχαριστούμε.
All the Greeks that supporting you.
And they did tremendously. We had a resounding victory.
Yes.
We doubled our victory majority from last year. Same Republican opponent. And a lot of Greek Americans support us, not just in Rhode Island, but outside of Rhode Island, here in Florida.
I know.
In New York, Connecticut, Massachusetts, all across this great country.
They should be all, you know, you guys united. And not like the one from Palestinian. They come on the internet, if you hear these videos go around, where they said the president, right in the Washington, there was a lady, you know, and that was very embarrassing for the United States of America.
She's not speaking that way. It denigrates her position. It makes her look bad.
I feel so sorry about...
People are very emotional.
I feel so sorry about the Palestinian people, because we love Palestinians.
It's very sad too.
And you know something? A lot of Americans, a lot of people, they now start hitting the Palestinians because that lady and the other lady, who is very radical. And this is going to blow Trump, we're going to blow the United States, and this kind of stuff, you know.
And it's sad that both sides of the aisle have really, in the last 5 years, have really become very outspoken, and that's totally wrong. You need civility in this country. That's what makes proud the United States, is have civil discourse in Washington, D.C., and that's how you're going to accomplish it.
You know, I think when Obama was for 8 years, we have no problems. When Clinton was, or Bush, when the elections was over, everybody's going to work, and working united. We don't ask Obama, next day, you're out. Now, Trump is 2 years, and the Democratic Party, they keep attacking him like crazy. You know why they do that? The Democratic Party, they keep attacking him. The liars, and all the canalla. The CNN, NBC, CBS, all those people, why they attacking so much? Why?
It's unfortunate. I think there's too much emotion with the border. I believe that Congress should sit down and try to either create some type of border summit and get all the stakeholders involved and try to find some type of resolution. But anyhow,
I hope so.
I want to wish everyone here in Florida a happy new year, a prosperous new year, and hopefully we can get good results for our constituents here in the United States and here in Florida, but also our homeland of Greece and Cyprus, and try to resolve
that's
a lot
good.
Of issues.
That's good. And that's very good, because our gas is going down. Our gasoline is going down here in Florida.
Very surprisingly.
Nah. Today was 179 in Pasco County, which is very good per gallon. That was around 20 years ago, this price. Okay, nice
Excellent.
Talk to you.
Thank you very much.
Καλό βράδυ. Bye-bye.